Now, we're gathered here together with a purpose, with a reason. We're in a holy place. We're in a holy ground. This place has been separated especially to worship God. This place is not used for anything else. We don't use it for parties. We don't use it for any type of gatherings, but we use it for God's glory. And the saints and people gather here together to worship the Lord.
Ooh, here's what people think. Like, people are getting mixed up, all right? They thought so many thoughts about Jesus. Did he stop? No, he still went to the cross and he died for you and me. He didn't say, oh, they called me a loser. No, he went there. He embarrassed himself. He humbled himself. They whipped him. They nailed him to the cross. For what? For me? He died for me? Did I deserve it? I definitely didn't deserve it.
What's gonna happen? I sat in this pew when I was a visitor. I sat in the fifth pew, and I would hear the word of God, and I would think to myself, if the Lord came right now, I know I'm going to hell. And I'm thankful to God that He spoke to me through the words of His word.
My friends, to experience how it feels to be in this church, and how it feels to get saved, because it feels so amazing.
Amen. Yes, it does.
And sometimes I just, when I'm praying, I just cry and I just ask God, please help him.
Amen. Help him see. That's really good.
Yes, he is.
I think God, every time, no matter how I'm living, even though I'm going to my fullest, to my best, I think God for telling me we need to fix something, because I think God, like, he still cares about me. He cares so much to tell me we need to fix this. I've been changed and I've been set free, and I don't have those chains that the devil has been bounding me up.
Amen, amen.
Thank God. Praise God for victory.
And I just want to, like, ask God to continue to hold me, and I want you guys to be keeping me in my prayer.
Words to describe where I was. I was in drugs, I was in confusion. I wanted to kill myself. I tried many times. One night I just fell on my knees and cried and told God to end my life right then and there. And I asked Him, I told Him to. And the next morning, I was still awake. I woke up. I woke up. Even when I fled to Him to let me go, I woke up. He has a purpose for your life. Amen.
Sacrifice unto the Lord yourself, your heart, because He wants to do something new in you. Amen. He wants to do something brand new. He wants to burn everything that doesn't please Him. He wants to do something
new.
And all these kids that have been having in these schools, think about it, that could have been you. And today you have the privilege to get saved and give your life to Jesus. We thank God for this young man that just came right now to the altar. But there's more here that are not saved right now. Think about it. If you would have been right now in that classroom where that person was shooting, what would you have done? You have now an opportunity to give your life to Jesus. Are you going to stay there and just ignore it? That could have been you.
Thank you. Yes, help him do it.
Thank you for this soul.
Thank you for this soul. God, take it. In the name of Jesus. He has humbled himself before you and asked you for forgiveness, Lord. Father, of all his wrongdoing, of all his sin, Lord, and we ask you that you will make him a new creature, Lord. That you will change his heart and give him a new heart, a clean heart. Father, we ask you that you will dwell in him from now on. Father, come into his heart. Father, show him the path.
Hallelujah.